And we're back after fighting GGPO. We have switched sides. On to Honda. There we go. Oh, magic of the biggest kiss. To which he says on IRC, ew, rightfully so. Now, this is usually a terrible matchup for Honda, but I can handle it, right? Now, granted, it involves me getting psychic DP'd. A lot. Okay. Now I just have to hope you can't reverse them. There we go. And that's how Honda rolls. Constant sword OGO exploitation. Honda basically almost always gets raped by fireball passes. Fortunately, since fireball isn't that great, and I'm pretty good at handling fireballs, psychic DP. Well, then again, you're exactly what I was going to go for. I mean, if there's nothing else that Honda could really do at that range besides maybe spot stomp, and you think Jeb DP would beat that too. He's probably going to go back to Chum. Oh, the trooper. Ken's jab DP is notoriously hard to punish on black, it's basically safe in most situations. I think I want some extremely close to it. But even then, as a missed butt stomp. Boots and come out that smell. Pondit's why job not to get into that situation. Go back to Dee Jay. Much easier to get handled and done. Regular medium multi kick. Ow. Oh, I can't believe I missed the cross up there. Oh, the cover end that always fucks me up. Most people look at Dee Jay as the poor man's Guile, but in truth, he's probably... Guile has good normals that can cover almost every situation, but Dee Jay has a few really good normals that serve me really well, so he's about just as good, a bit easier to play, and much more combo potential. Well, Sammy Jarvis and Vega doesn't do that same player. Press kick is also remarkably safe, normal, special move. Again, like jab DP for a Ken, but doesn't matter so much in this matchup. And that's it for this set.